Hello everyone, this is Dr. Jay Mehta here from Mumbai. In today's video, we are going to try and discuss something about low AMH. Now, low AMH can also be called as poor ovarian reserve. This is a specific subset of patients who come to us in assisted reproduction, where the lady or the female partner has a poor ovarian reserve or a diminished ovarian reserve. And one of the markers of ovarian reserve is AMH, okay, or anti-Müllerian hormone. So there are certain concepts which I want to clear regarding AMH and the testing of AMH before I speak about the low AMH value. In the ovary, now you know that every lady has two ovaries, one on the right and one on the left. There is a specific amount of ovarian reserve. It's like a petrol tank, you know, your car has a petrol tank. The minute you ignite your car and you start running your car, and start driving, the petrol keeps on going less. There is a fixed number of primordial ovarian follicles which are present in the ovary of every lady at birth. And after birth, this reserve keeps on decreasing. So AMH tries to give you a surrogate marker of how much potential reserve of these primordial follicles you have in your ovary. That is the importance of doing this test, because while you do this, it gives you an idea as to how you are going to respond to injections or how you are going to respond to hormonal stimulation, how much is the reserve, how good is the success rate of IVF or any other form of assisted reproduction going to be in your body, and it will also give you some clue about the quality of embryos that you will form. It is important to understand that AMH is not cyclical, that means it is not related to your periods, okay? You can do the test for AMH at any time of the month. That is very important. It need not be done fasting. It's not mandatory that the test has to be done fasting. And it is a commonly available test. So now, if you otherwise look at the categories in which we try to divide women based on AMH, low AMH or poor ovarian reserve or diminished ovarian reserve is a category where typically if you go by the standard laboratories, AMH value is less than 1.5. That is sort of the definition which we try to give to women who have a low AMH. The other thing you should understand is that when you have a low AMH does not mean you cannot have children. There is nothing like that, okay? There are so many women who have children who would be having low AMH, but because they conceived on their own, because they became pregnant, they never tested their AMH. Likewise, women with low AMH also can have healthy children. They might need assisted reproduction, but it is not mandatory that every lady with low AMH needs to do IVF only. So that is one very important misconception which needs to be cleared. And finally, though once you detect the AMH is low, there are certain medications which are available which temporarily enhance the follicle count. Remember, there is nothing which can reverse an aging ovary. There is nothing which can reverse your age. Likewise, there is nothing which gives you a sure shot guarantee and increases your AMH value by double or triple or whatever. All those things are a bit too far-fetched, okay? But you must understand that there are certain molecules which may benefit women with low ovarian reserve in slightly enhancing the count of their eggs, which are available for recruitment, and might benefit them in conception, especially with assisted reproduction or with natural conception. Now, apart from AMH, there is something else also which all fertility specialists look at, and that is something called as antral follicle count or AFC. Now, this is typically assessed on the second or on the third day of your period and is done with an internal ultrasound. That's a vaginal ultrasound, and the size of the follicles is assessed in both your ovaries. Now, normally it should be approximately 10. The total count of antral follicles in both the ovaries should be 10. Any count of less than 6 is typically what we believe to be as diminished ovarian reserve. And that is an important thing because AFC and AMH both go hand in hand in our clinical decision making as to which treatment is going to be the most appropriate treatment for the female partner. We are going to cover this series of lectures where we are going to be describing about low AMH, stimulation techniques, advanced procedures for women with low AMH. But you should remember one thing, since this is a question which can arise a lot of anxiety, should there be more questions on this, you can feel free to post them in our comments box. Me or one of my team members will try to get back to you on this very soon. Thank you so much.